And a little attack here now, and this is coming from Cesar Grajales, the Colombian. Rides for Jittery Joe's Coffee.
Cesar
winning that stage over Lance.
That stage win that he did was huge.
When Cesar Grajales won on top of Brasstown Ball in Tour of Georgia, that was a real highlight for the team.
Rise, the man I didn't think I'd be calling, I admit that. Cesar Grajales of Colombia, Jittery Joe's, is going to get the stage.
It's tough to groom a rider. I mean, Cesar was our GC guy from 2004, and now he's been picked up by a big team. When we found out that we weren't going to have Cesar back, then I started looking around. I was like, okay, I need to find a leader.
Can you hear this? The scrape.
I'm a professional cyclist. I've been a pro since 2001. And I'm new to the Jittery Joe's Kalahari cycling team.
I was in Europe for a year racing with Sonny Duval Pro Deer, and my phone rang and it was Mike. He's like, hey, what is it gonna take to get you on the team? He was so enthusiastic, and I guess that's really what I was looking for. More than anything else, it was the fact that somebody really wanted me on the team.
Tim is the other main reason that I want to race for the team.
I have a great appreciation for Tim, and I'm sure that he doesn't even realize how much I look up to him and appreciate.
I hope so. I'd love to be a role model for the other guys, just because I know how hard it is.
I totally would have done that.
You got something right here.
I know, I'm saving it for later.
Well, like, the thing that I was sick of was you working for other guys that didn't need you working for them.
Christian thought he had one more real strategy to learn. Maybe this is a new strategy that Tim found out in Europe.
Can't tell you how many times this year I just hear this voice coming from behind telling me, Christian, shut up. You don't need to be on the microphone so much. Just race your damn bike. And I turn around and it's Tim.
You look good, man. You're going to have a good year.
Thanks.
Picking up Tim adds a real leader. And even though he's raced for a huge Division I team in Spain, it hasn't spoiled him.
I was in the races and I know what it takes to win a race. I just didn't really have the chance to show that last year. So it's my job to either be the guy to win the race or kick somebody's ass so that they win the race. Any one of us can win the race.
Jeff Hopkins, our Australian sprinter, he'll be back.
I tend to be a fair bit faster than most other people, so that's the biggest thing that I bring to the team.
Thad Doolin comes to us from the Colavita cycling team.
You know, I thought it would be a great opportunity, so I said sign me up.
Jeff Kabush, world-renowned mountain biker, and he's going to race on the road, and he's going to really surprise some people.
Look forward to trying to give some of the bigger teams a run for their money at the big races.
One of the biggest parts of this team is a very close-knit group of guys, and the relationship between the riders is not necessarily strengthened when we're on the road, but strengthened through the fact that it's tested very heavily when we're on the road.
Wanted man in California, wanted man in Buffalo, wanted man in Kansas City, wanted man in Ohio.
Living in close quarters for a long period of time with the same group of guys can be very trying.
We all might all be crashing on a floor down in a basement, and you know, you have to be almost obnoxiously social.
I know when the season comes around, I get my fill of those guys, you know.
I'm a slave to fashion.
Yeah, Christian's a pretty boy. You should see our bathroom. He has so much product. It's unbelievable.
More products? Are you kidding me? The guy's got like all these like high dollar Kiehl's shit in the bathroom. That's bullshit. Well, I'd say we have an equal amount of products.
It's part of the job is just spending a lot of time on the road, in the van, living in a hotel.
Like being a bit of a schizo, I think, leading two separate lives, but it's hard to be away from your family and that, obviously.
Why are you doing this? You know, you're making $250 a month in a stipend, and then you have to make, you know, prize money to pay your rent or to buy your food for that week. You know, why are you doing this to yourself?
I think fear is based on uncertainty. I mean, I know that it's gonna hurt.
You get a reward occasionally. All it is pain.
Ironic. athlete makes me feel good even though I'm wasted.
It's sick and twisted, but I think most guys that are doing this really get off on that. I mean, that's part of the reason why they're here.
It doesn't come enough for anyone, just that little hint.
I can't think of anything else that I could be doing right now that would give that sort of satisfaction.
Yeah, I mean, it's the worst drug imaginable. Once you get a taste, you just want more of it.